Dear students, today we are going to study a new topic. Its name is permutations and combinations. This has a lot of applications in scientific field and in our real world life also. First, I shall present some problems on this permutations and combinations. First thing is, here we are concerned with counting arrangements of elements of a set. Suppose we have three cards labeled A, B and C respectively. Consider the following problems. Problem 1 is, two cards at a time are selected from a set of three cards and placed side by side. How many different sequences of letters are possible? Solution is, there are 6 possible sequences. They are AB, AC, BA, BC, CA and CB. Here we are considering the ordered pairs of elements of the set ABC, because the order is important in this problem. AB means first A and then B. AC means first A and then C, and we are concerned with the order of elements in the sequence. Problem 2 is, if two cards are selected from a set of three cards, how many different hands are possible? In a hand of cards, the order in which cards are received does not matter. Thus, three hands are possible, namely AB, AC and BC. In the first case, the order is important, and in the second case, the order is not important, and this will lead to the definition of permutation and combination. The distinction between these problems is that the order of letters is important in the first problem, but not in the second. Arrangements of objects is called permutation if the order is important, and a combination if it is not. Before coming to the problems connected with or results connected with permutations and combinations, first we are going to study a new thing, new principle, that is called multiplication principle of counting. For considering that theory, we consider another problem. Suppose that there are two different ways to reach from A to B and three different ways from B to C. Find the number of different ways from A to C. Let the different ways from A to B be denoted by L, M, and that from B to C be denoted by PQR. Then a way from A to C is a sequence of the form LP, LQ and LR, and MB, MQ and MR. Thus, the number of different ways is equal to 2 into 3 equal to 6. Generalizing the above problem, we get the following counting rule. We call this rule as multiplication principle of counting. The problem states that if there are n1 ways to make a decision d1, and for each of these ways, there are n2 ways to make a decision d2, and no matter what choices were made for d1 and d2, there are n3 ways to make a decision d3. Then there are n1 into n2 into n3 ways to make all decisions. This problem can also be stated as, if there are n1 ways from a place A to B and there are n2 ways from B to C, then there are n1 into n2 ways from A to C. Let us see a problem. A coin is tossed 3 times and the outcomes are recorded. How many outcomes are there? The choices are 2, 4, 8 and 16. The solution is, there are 2 possibilities, head or tail, for the outcome of a toss if we denote H and T for head and tail respectively, then a sample outcome of the experiment is HTH. So, by the multiplication principle of counting, the number of outcomes is 2 into 2 into 2. This 2 means that there are 2 possible choices for the first experiment, and this 2 means that there are 2 choices for the second experiment, and this means that there are 2 choices for the third one, which is equal to 8. Let us see another problem. How many different 3-letter words with or without meaning can be formed from the first 10 letters of the English alphabet if repetitions are not allowed? A 3-letter word can be viewed as 3 cells arranged in a row as given below. There are 10 possibilities for filling the first cell. After filling the first cell, there are 9 possibilities for the second cell, because we are not allowing repetitions. There are 9 possibilities for the second one. After filling the first and the second, there are 8 possibilities for the third cell. So, by the multiplication principle of counting, the required number is equal to 10 into 9 into 8, which is equal to 720. Next, we are considering a slight variation of the above problem. If repetitions are allowed, then there are 10 possibilities for each cell. So, the number of 3-lettered words is equal to 10 into 10 into 10, which is equal to 10 cube. Consider another problem. How many 3-digit even numbers can be formed using the digits 2, 3, 5, 6, 7 and 8 if no digit is repeated? The choices are 60, 75, 108 and 20. The solution is, a 3-digit number is of the form ABC, where A, B, C are integers in the set 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. Since a number is even, there are 3 choices for C. They are 2, 6 or 8. Also, there are 5 choices for B and 4 choices for A. So, by the multiplication principle of counting, the required number is 4 into 5 into 3, which is equal to 60. Therefore, the answer is the first one, A. In this case, if repetitions are allowed, then there are 6 choices for the first and second letters. So, the required number is 6 into 6 into 3, which is equal to 108. Consider another problem. How many 5-digit palindromic numbers can be formed using the numbers in the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9? A 5-digit palindromic number is of the form ABCBA, where A, B, C are integers in the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Since the first and the last, the second and the fourth digits are the same, the number of palindromic numbers is, because the first A has 9 choices, B also has 9 choices, and C also has 9 choices. Therefore, the number of palindromic numbers is 9 into 9 into 9, which is equal to 729. If no digit is repeated, number of palindromes is equal to 9 into 8 into 7, which is equal to 504. Let us see another problem. How many 6-digit palindromic numbers can be formed using the numbers in the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Here the solution is a 6-digit palindromic number is of the form ABCCBA, where ABC are integers in the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So, the record number, because we are considering only ABC, there are 9 choices for A and 9 choices for B and 9 choices for C. Therefore, the record number is 9 into 9 into 9, which is equal to 729. If no digit is repeated, then the number of palindromes is equal to 9 into 8 into 7, which is equal to 504. From the above problem, you can see that number of 5-digit palindromic numbers and 6-digit palindromic numbers are same. Therefore, we can generalize that problem in this way. From the above problems, we have the following. Number of n-digit palindromic numbers is equal to 9 raised to n plus 1 by 2 if n is odd, which is equal to 9 raised to n by 2 if n is even. Let us see another problem. A medical researcher classifies humans according to one of 3 skin colors, comma, one of 8 blood types and one of 2 sexes. How many classes are possible? The choices are 24, 48, 16 and 6. Since the classification is based on skin colors, blood types and sexes, comma, by the multiplication principle of counting, there are 3 into 8 into 2, which is equal to 48 classes. Therefore, the answer is B. Consider the following problem. Assume that a student identification number consists of 2 letters selected from the set A, B, C, D, E and F, followed by a sequence of 5 digits selected from the set 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., 9. If repetitions are allowed, how many identification numbers are possible? The solution is there are 6 possibilities for each of the 2 letters and there are 10 possibilities for each of the 5 digits. Thus, by the multiplication principle of counting, there are 6 into 6 into 10 into 10 into 10 into 10 into 10, that is equal to 36 into 10 raised to 5 different possible identification numbers. If repetitions are not allowed, then there are 6 into 5 into 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6, which is equal to 9,07,200 numbers. Consider another problem. A communication signal can be transmitted from a point A to one of 7 possible satellites, after which it is relayed to one of 50 possible ground stations and sent to a point B. Find the number of different ways to send a signal from A to B. Here the solution is there are 7 into 50 into 1, 350 ways, because there are 7 satellites and 50 ground stations. Therefore, the solution is 7 into 50 into 1, which is equal to 350. Permutations. An arrangement of a given set of distinct points in definite order without repetitions is called a permutation. There are 6 different permutations of the set 1, 2, 3. They are 1, first is 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, 3, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, 1. Consider another problem. How many different permutations can be formed from the set 1, 2, 3 and 4? Each permutation consists of 4 digits. First digits can be selected in any of 4 ways. Second digit can be selected in any one of 3 ways, and the third digit any of 2 ways, and the last digit in any one way. Thus, by the multiplication principle of counting, there are 4 choices for the first one, 3 choices for the second one, 2 choices for the third one, and 1 choice for the last one. Therefore, by the multiplication principle of counting, there are 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which is equal to 24 different permutations. Similarly, the number of different permutations on the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is 5 factorial, which is equal to 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Generalizing the above result, we can arrive at the following. The number of permutations of a set with n distinct objects is n into n minus 1 into etc. 3 into 2 into 1, which is equal to n factorial. An arrangement of r objects from a set of n objects is called a permutation of n objects taken r at a time. It is denoted by NPR. By the multiplication principle of counting, the number of permutations of n objects taken r at a time is NPR is equal to n into n minus 1 into etc. n minus r plus 1. Using factorial notation, NPR is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial. Another formula for finding number of permutations. Number of permutations of n objects, if P1 objects are of one kind, comma, P2 objects are of the second kind, etc., PK objects are of the kth kind, and the rest, if any, are of different kind, is n factorial divided by P1 factorial into P2 factorial into etc. PK factorial. Consider the problem. How many permutations can be formed from the set A, B, C, D, E taken 2 at a time? Here n is equal to 5. Number of elements in the set is n, which is equal to 5, and r is equal to 2. So, the number of permutations is equal to 5 P2, which is equal to 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial, which is equal to 20. Consider another problem. In the runoff of a state lottery, there are 10 ticket holders in a drawing for 3 prizes, a rupees 4 lakh prize, a rupees 2 lakh prize, and a rupees 1 lakh prize. If no person can win more than one prize, how many outcomes are possible? The solution is, here n is 10 and r is 3. Therefore, the number of outcomes is equal to 10 by 3, which is equal to 10 factorial divided by 7 factorial, which is equal to 10 into 9 into 8, which is equal to 720. consider another problem. Find the number of permutations of the letters of the word Malayalam. Here, the number of letters in the word is 9. Number of A's is equal to 4. Number of L's is equal to 2. Number of M's is equal to 2. Rest are all different. Therefore, the record number of permutations is 9 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 2 factorial into 2 factorial, which is equal to 3780. Let us see another problem. In how many ways can the letters of the word permutations be arranged if the words start with P and end with N? The solution is, after arranging P and N as the first and last letters, arrange the remaining 9 letters in between. Since T appears 2 times in the word, the number of ways is equal to 9 factorial divided by 2 factorial, which is equal to 18,14,400. Let us see another problem. It is required to seat 5 boys and 4 girls in a row so that girls occupy the even places. How many arrangements are possible? The solution is, label the chairs in the row by 1, 2, 3, etc., 9. First, arrange girls in positions 2, 4, 6, and 8. This can be done in 4 factorial ways. Arrange boys in the remaining positions, that is 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. This can be done in 5 factorial ways. So, by the multiplication principle of counting, number of ways is 4 factorial into 5 factorial, which is equal to 24 into 120, which is equal to 2880. Here we are using both the theory of permutations and the theory of multiplication principle of counting. Consider another problem. How many 7-digit numbers can be formed from digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7 and 9, which are divisible by 10 and no digits repeated? And the second thing is, which are divisible by 5 and no digits repeated. Since a number is divisible by 10, the last digit is 0. Arrange the remaining digits in 1 to 6 positions. The first digit is any number in 1, 2, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So, the number of choices for the first digit is 6. 5 choices for the second, comma, 4 choices for the third, etc. Therefore, the required number is equal to 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which is equal to 720. The second thing is, since the number is divisible by 5, the last digit is either 0 or 5. If the last digit is 0, then by 1, the number of 7-digit numbers is 720. If the last digit is 5, then the first digit is any number in 1, 2, 3, 7 and 9, digits which are different from 0 and 5. So, the number of choices for the first digit is 5. After selecting the first digit, second digit has 5 choices. Here we can include 0 also. The third digit has 4 choices and fourth digit has 3 choices, etc. So, the number of 7 digit numbers with the last digit 5 is 5 into 5 factorial, which is 5 into 120, which is equal to 600. Thus, the required number is equal to 720 plus 600, which is equal to 1320. Consider another problem. The board of directors authorizes a bank to promote 3 of its top 12 executives to the rank of first secretary, 1 to the rank of second secretary, and then the rank of third secretary. In how many ways can the individuals be selected for promotion? Label the executives 1, 2, etc., 11, 12, and suppose that we first choose a first secretary, the second secretary, and then the third secretary. In this case, 1, 5, 7 and 7, 1, 5 are different selections. Because in the first one, 1, 5, 7, we are selecting first one as the first secretary, fifth one as the second secretary, and seventh one as the third secretary. But in the second case, that is 7, 1, 5, we are selecting seventh one as the first secretary, first one as the second secretary, and fifth one as the third secretary. So, the order is important. Thus, the number of selections is 12P3, which is equal to 12 into 11 into 10, which is equal to 1320. Consider another problem. A coin is tossed 5 times and the resulting sequences of heads and tails are recorded. How many sequences have at least 3 heads? How many sequences have at most 3 heads? A sequence in this problem is an array of 5 cells as given below. Each cell has 2 choices, head or tail. If you denote the head by H and the tail by T, then an outcome of the experiment is H, T, H, T, H. To say that a sequence has at least 3 heads means one of the following is true. There are exactly 3 heads. Number of such sequences is 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial. There are exactly 4 heads. Number of such sequences is 5 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 1 factorial. There are exactly 5 heads. Number of such sequences is 5 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 0 factorial. Here 0 factorial means it is defined as 1. Therefore, the required number of sequences is 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial plus 5 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 1 factorial plus 5 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 0 factorial, which is equal to 10 plus 5 plus 1, which is equal to 16. Second case, to say that a sequence has at most 3 heads means one of the following is true. There are exactly 0 heads. Number of such sequences is 5 factorial divided by 0 factorial into 5 factorial. There is exactly 1 head. Number of such sequences is 5 factorial divided by 1 factorial into 4 factorial. there are exactly two heads, number of such sequences is 5 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 3 factorial. There are exactly 3 heads, number of such sequences is 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial. Thus, the recorded number of sequences is 5 factorial divided by 0 factorial into 5 factorial plus 5 factorial divided by 1 factorial into 4 factorial plus 5 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 3 factorial plus 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial, which is equal to 26. Next, we are going to define what is meant by combinations. A subset of R objects selected from a set of n objects is called a combination of n objects taken R at a time. Number of combinations of n objects taken R at a time is denoted by NCR. NCR is equal to NPR. NPR denotes the number of permutations of n objects taken R at a time. NCR is equal to NPR divided by R factorial, which is equal to n factorial divided by R factorial into n minus R factorial. Let us see a problem. How many different subsets of 1, 2, 3, etc., 10 contain exactly 6 elements? Number of 6 element subsets is equal to the number of combinations of 10 objects taken 6 at a time. Therefore, the recorded number is equal to 10C6, which is equal to 10 factorial divided by 6 factorial into 4 factorial, which is equal to 210. See another problem. Prove that 1C1 plus 2C1 plus etc. NC1 is equal to N plus 1 C2 for N greater than or equal to 1. The solution is, we have a 1C1 plus 2C1 plus etc. NC1 is equal to 1C1 is 1 factorial divided by 0 factorial into 1 factorial, which is equal to 1. 2C1 is 2 factorial divided by 1 factorial into 1 factorial, which is equal to 2, etc., which is equal to 1 plus 2 plus etc. plus n, which is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2, which is equal to n plus 1 C2. Let us see another problem. How many different 5-member committees can be formed from a delegation of 9 members? Clearly, a 5-member committee is a selection of 5 members from a delegation of 9. So, the recorded number is equal to 9C5, which is equal to 9 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 4 factorial, which is equal to 126. Consider another problem. Find the number of combinations of 30 objects taken 8 at a time. Another one is number of combinations of 30 objects taken 22 at a time. The solution for the first one is 30C8, which is equal to 30 factorial divided by 8 factorial into 22 factorial. Its value is 58,52,925. The problem considered in the second case is 30C22 its value is 30 factorial divided by 22 factorial into 8 factorial. Its value is also equal to 58,52,925. From the above two cases, it is evident that NCR is equal to NCN minus R. Also, we have NCR plus NCR minus 1 is equal to N plus 1 CR. Consider another problem. How many different 7 card hands with all black cards can be dealt from a deck of 52 cards? A deck of playing cards contains 52 cards. These 52 cards is again divided into 4 suits. They are clubs, its a figure is given here, hearts, diamonds and spades. 13 cards in each suit is again classified into, the symbol for ace is A, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, Q, that is a symbol for queen, K, that is a symbol for king, and J, that is a symbol for jack. Clubs and spades have black colors and hearts and diamonds have red colors. So, the number of black cards is 26 and that of red cards is also 26. Number of J is 4, number of K is 4, number of Q is 4, number of A's is 4, etc. Therefore, the solution is, since the number of black cards is 26, number of different 7 card hands is equal to 26C7, which is equal to 26 factorial divided by 7 factorial into 19 factorial. Another problem. 5 balls are selected from a box that contains 6 red balls and 5 black balls. How many different selections containing 3 red balls and 2 black balls are possible? Solution. 3 red balls can be selected in 6C3, which is equal to 20 ways. 2 black balls can be selected in 5C2, which is equal to 10 ways. So, the number of such selections is 6C3 into 5C2, which is equal to 200. Here we are using the multiplication principle of counting. Let us see another problem. How many 5 card hands with 3 red cards and 2 black cards can be dealt from a deck of 52 cards? A hand of 3 red cards and 2 black cards can be formed in 2 steps. Step 1, deal 3 cards from the 26 red cards in the deck. Second step, deal 2 cards from the 26 black cards in the deck. Step 1 can be performed in 26 C3 ways. Step 2 can be performed in 26 C2 ways. So, by the multiplication principle of counting, 2 steps can be performed in 26 C3 into 26 C2 ways. The answer is 84 lakhs and 5000 ways. Consider another problem. A coin is tossed 100 times and the sequence of heads and tails are recorded. How many sequences have at least 2 heads? Solution is, the record number is equal to total number of sequences minus number of sequences that do not have at least two heads. Therefore, the record number is total number of sequences minus number of sequences that do not have at least two heads. The total number of sequences is 2 into 2, etc., 100 times. That is equal to 2 raised to 100. Total number of sequences that do not have at least 2 heads is equal to 100 factorial divided by 0 factorial into 100 factorial plus 100 factorial divided by 1 factorial into 99 factorial, which is equal to 1 plus 100, which is equal to 101. Therefore, the record number is 2 raised to 100 minus 101. Let us see another problem. In how many ways can one select a cricket team of 11 from 17 players in which only 5 players can bowl if each cricket team of 11 must include exactly 4 bowlers? Bowlers can be selected in 5C4 ways. Number of players remaining after the selection of bowlers is 17 minus 5, which is equal to 12. Remaining 7 players can be selected in 12C7 ways. Therefore, the number of selections is 5C4 into 12C7, which is equal to 3916. Here also we are using the multiplication principle of counting. Consider another problem. A modeling agency agrees to provide a fashion house with 3 models each week for 52 weeks. The contract requests that in no 2 weeks will exactly same 3 models be sent. What is the minimum number of models needed? If n is the number of models, then the problem is to find minimum n for which NC3 is greater than or equal to 52. That is, n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 is greater than or equal to 52 into 3 factorial, which is equal to 312. When n is equal to 1, the left hand side of the above inequality becomes 0. Therefore, we arrive at a contradiction. When n is equal to 2, then also the left hand side becomes 0 and we arrive at a contradiction. And continue in this way, when n is equal to 7, then also we arrive at a contradiction. Therefore, the answer is n is equal to 8. In this class, we have learned about multiplication principle of counting, permutations and combinations, and some circumstances in which this theory can be applied. I hope that this class is very useful for your further study. Thank you.